discuss about continuous and discontinuous modes of operation of single phase controlled rectifier. Last class I have discussed about single phase fully controlled rectifier with RLE load. Let's extend our discussion to continuous and discontinuous modes of operation of single phase full wave converter with RLE load. This continuous and discontinuous modes of operation of single phase converter is very important. The reason behind it is that in case of automatic control system or feedback control system of converter, sometimes it is found that continuous conduction mode or discontinuous conduction mode is not suitable from stability point of view. Now, the continuous conduction mode, that the load current is continuously flowing, and discontinuous conduction mode means there is some halt of this load current, or for some duration of time current is zero. So let's discuss these things. There are two modes of operations of this single phase converter. Mode 1, thyristor 1 and 2 will conduct, and in mode 2, 3 and 4. Both modes are equivalent to each other. So here we will analyze only mode 1. Based on that one, we can find other important parameters. So let's see. In mode 1, when 1 and 2 is conducted, then the equivalent circuit diagram can be seen here. Applying KVL in mode 1, we can write LDI dt plus RI plus E is equal to Vm sin theta, where I is the current flowing through the circuit in mode 1. Now, solving this equation, we will get this current I is equal to Vm by root under R square plus omega L square sin theta minus phi. Here phi is the lagging angle. As the load is inductive, so the current will lag the supply voltage by certain angle. That angle is here phi, and phi is equal to tan inverse omega L by R. So, I is equal to Vm by root under R square plus omega L square. This R square plus omega L square is nothing but impedance of the circuit. Sin theta minus phi plus k e to the power minus r by r into t minus e by r. K is a constant. It is to be found out based on the initial or final condition of the circuit. Now, let's assume that 1 and 2 is fired at an angle alpha. Then, from that point, current will start building. And that current, let's assume, is the minimum current, I mean. So, substituting these values in equation number 1, we can get the value of k. And k is equal to I minimum plus E by R minus Vm by root under R square plus omega L square sin alpha minus phi e to the power R alpha by L omega. Once we have got k, then final current expression we can get from equation number 1. So, that just substitute the value of this k in equation number 1, you will get I is equal to Vm by Z sin theta minus phi minus E by R plus I minimum plus E by R minus Vm by Z sin alpha minus phi e to the power R alpha by omega L into e to the power minus R T by L. So this is the current at any instant of time T. Let's see how the current looks like. See, here 0 to pi input voltage is positive, and pi to 2 pi it is negative. And at pi by 6, thyristor number 1 and 2 is triggered. So it will continue from pi by 6 to 7 pi by 6, as already we have discussed. So at pi by 6, whatever current you are getting, that will be your minimum current. Then mode 1 will continue from pi by 6 to 7 pi by 6. And at 7 pi by 6, thyristor number 3 and 4 is triggered. And this mode will continue till 13 pi by 6, or you can say pi by 6. So mode 1 is equivalent to mode 2. Step of the output current is also same. So that's why we are analyzing only the mode 1 current. This extra conduction from pi to 7 pi by 6 is because of inductive load. Likewise, in the second mode, conduction from 2 pi to 13 pi by 6 is because of same reason. So we can say that end of mode 1 is equal to starting of mode 2. So the current at theta is equal to, in general expression, we can replace this one, pi by 6 by alpha, then we will get I minimum is equal to Vm by impedance of the circuit minus of sine alpha minus pi. Here pi by 6 is now replaced by alpha. Here in the waveform, alpha is pi by 6 minus of sine alpha minus pi e to the power minus r pi by l omega divided by 1 minus e to the power minus r pi by l omega minus of e by r. So equation number 4, based on the initial condition of mode 2, we can get I minimum. Here the current shown is only continuous conduction, and it will become discontinuous conduction mode if I minimum is equal to 0. So to get critical value of alpha, that means boundary condition between continuous conduction mode and discontinuous conduction mode, we can get by making equation 4 equal to 0, I minimum equal to 0, and you will get alpha is equal to, alpha critical is equal to 5 minus sine inverse 1 minus e to the power minus pi by 10 pi divided by 1 plus e to the power minus pi by 10 pi, then multiplied by e by Vm cos pi. So here we have got critical value of alpha. So if our firing angle is greater than alpha critical, greater than equal to alpha critical, then the inductor current or output current will be 0. So you can say that for discontinuous conduction mode, if alpha is greater than equal to alpha critical, then it will be discontinuous conduction mode, as the current will become 0. And for alpha less than equal to alpha critical, it will be our continuous conduction mode. That means current will never be 0, it will continue to conduct. Alternately, you can say that if your load impedance is reduced, then current will increase and it will go into continuous conduction mode. And if load impedance is increased, then current will reduce and the system can go into discontinuous conduction mode. This is one way to shift from continuous to discontinuous or discontinuous to continuous conduction mode. These continuous and discontinuous conduction modes are very important for closed loop operation or automatic control systems to stabilize the complete converter system. Let's find the parameters of the circuit, like RMS output current and average output current. The RMS current of the SCR is found from equation number 3. The square root of 1 by complete time period alpha 2 pi plus alpha I square d theta. This I you will get from equation number 3. Then RMS output current is equal to the square root of RMS output current for mode 1 plus RMS output current square for mode 2. So as these two currents are equal, and similar in nature. So it can be added up, and the RMS output current will be equal to square root 2 of RMS output current for mode 1. Then average current of the SCRs, 1 by 2 pi alpha 2 pi plus alpha I d theta. It is for only mode 1. Average output current can be found out is equal to twice of the average thyristor current in mode 1. So today I have discussed about continuous and discontinuous modes of operation of single phase full wave converter with RLE load. There we have seen that by changing the value of firing angle alpha or by changing the load impedance, we can shift our complete converter to continuous or discontinuous modes of operation. These are important for closed loop control systems. Then we have found out the RMS and average current through each SCR, then RMS and average output current of the complete converter. Thank you.